Example 7 is next. In example 7, we're going to just use Gaussian elimination. In other words, we want to put our matrix in row echelon form. So we start. The first thing that you notice is in the second row, we are missing a y. And so we write x plus 0, y plus z is equal to 6. It is now time to write our augmented matrix. Here we go. 1, negative 1, 2, and 4. 1, 0, 1, 6. 2, negative 3, 5, and 4. And finally, 3, 2, negative 1, and 1. First go, achieved. The first entry, the first row is equal to 1. Now what we want is, we want the first entry in the second row, the first entry in the third row, and the first entry in the fourth row to be equal to 0. Let's quickly write down what our goal is right now. We have a check mark, and we know that we can use only multiples of row 1. So we have row 2 plus negative 1, row 1 will be the new row 2. Row 3 plus negative 2, row 1 will be the new row 3. And finally, row 4 plus negative 3, row 1 will be the new row 4. So let's write what should we write. Well, at least the first row, which will not change, 1, negative 1, 2, and 4. And let's do a little bit of arithmetic. Yes, just arithmetic. Nothing more complicated. We have 1, 0, 1, and 6. There is our row 2. And now we want negative row 1, which is negative 1, positive 1, negative 2, and negative 4. We add them, and that will be our new row 2. 0, 1, negative 1, and 2. So 0, 1, negative 1, and 2. There's our new row 2. Let's find our new row 3. For the new row 3, I'm going to move over here. There's plenty of space. We're going to do row 3. Row 3, which is 2, negative 3, 5, and 4, plus negative 2, row 1. We have negative 2, positive 2, negative 4, and negative 8. And 0, negative 1, negative 1, and negative 4. So this is our new row 3. Let's enter that one too. 0. We got a problem, sorry about that. 5 plus negative 4 is actually positive 1. Good thing that I caught it. Like I said, the math that we're doing is not that complicated. The mistakes are really easy to make. So, 0, negative 1, positive 1, and negative 4. And finally, we want row 4 plus negative 3, row 1. So, row 4, 3, 2, negative 1, and 1. There is our row 4. And we want to add to it negative 3, row 1. Negative 3, positive 3, negative 6, and negative 12. Quickly check, negative 3, positive 3, negative 6, and positive 12. Add up and get a new row 4. 0, 5, negative 7, and negative 11. Check again, 0, 5, negative 7, negative 11. Everything is good. There is our new row 4. 0, 5, negative 7, and negative 11. So first goal achieved. Let's see what we want next. We want the entry in the second row, second column to be equal to 1. And we want the entry in the third row, second column, to be equal to 0, and the entry in the fourth row and second column to also equal 0. To do so, we're only going to use multiples of row 2. So multiples of row 2 will be added. So add multiples of row 2. So here we go. Row 3 plus row 2 is the new row 3, and I only want to do one at a time. You'll see why in a second. Row 3 plus row 2. We have 0, negative 1, 1, and negative 4. There's our row 3. Plus row 2, we have 1. Sorry about that. 0, 1, negative 1, and 2. Let's add them together. We get 0, 0, 0, and negative 2. And right now, we run into a problem. Why do we run into a problem? Because we have 0x plus 0y plus 0z is equal to negative 2. In other words, 0 is equal to negative 2. When this happens, then the conclusion is no solution. And there's nothing more that you want to do, so you stop right here. You say the system has no solution, and you are done.